Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the second episode in the series Connections in relation to the City Skylines Mass Transit DLC. If you remember from the last video, I told you we would look at connecting the city using the metro system. We've already got ferries running backwards and forwards from one side to the other. These are piers which have got bus stations attached to them. We've got some bus lines running on both sides of this part of the city. You can see over here we've got a green line and we've got a blue line, and on the other side of the city we've got a red line and a yellow line, so pretty well connected. Also, whilst you were away, I did connect the city up using the monorail system, and here at this location we've got the train metro monorail hub. Now, that is a new part of the system within the Mass Transit DLC. I've connected up the rail line only to one line at the moment, and it's being used. You can see trains are coming in and out. You'll also notice that we've got bus stops close to the monorail. We've got one there. There's a bus stop. We've got a bus stop here, and there's a station. We've got a monorail there, but no bus stop connected yet. And over here, we've got a bus stop there and a bus stop there, and there is a monorail. And people will walk. They will walk from those locations and they walk from here to those locations. It would be handy to have a bus stop closer to this one, but that one I think there is fairly close. That's close enough. And it will pick people up and deliver them to the ferry station here. That's the bus station and ferry crossing. So, coming back to the initial proposition that we put a metro in place, let's have a look at what we've got with the station. Here, we've got a metro line in place. We can see by the shining green laser, and we can see by this zone here, that there is a metro line in place there. We don't have any other metro stations anywhere here, but there is one at the International Airport. The International Airport is over here, and you can see there's a metro line there. Now, it would be handy to get passengers from the rail station to the airport and vice versa, because this station here serves a station on this side of the city as well, and another one here close to the, what I call, local airport. So I think the first thing to do is to get a metro line across to the airport. That gives it another connection apart from the roads, and that will reduce some of the congestion. And once I've done that, it will then be a question of where else can I put a metro line to serve this city. Now, we've got bus lines around here, that's working fairly well, but not a lot down in this area. Certainly not a lot in this area apart from the rail station, and in this area that's pretty well devoid of any other transport links apart from the airport and the passenger station. So I think Autumn District would be a good place to get a metro station, and I think if we were to think about putting a line in place, the line would probably come from the station, perhaps across to this sort of location here, because we've already got a bus stop there, then across to this sort of location. We could then bring it round, do a pickup maybe over here close to the rail station, bring it across to this side, bring it back to this sort of area close to the railway station, bring it over here to the international airport, and then come back to the hub which serves our monorail and our rail station. So I think the answer is to let's kick it off and see how we get on. So we need to go to the metro. What we need to do is build tunnels, and the easiest one to build first is to go to an existing station, so that would be going across to the here. So we made the first tunnel. The next tunnel we decided would have to come in this sort of direction. So we'd actually come over here. But I need to put the station in place first. There's a bus stop there. And I think it would be handy if you could get a tube station in fairly close to it. So let's have a look. Pick up the metro station. If I drop it here, I can connect it to that bus line. I'm only going to take one building out. We'll go for it. We'll drop it in there. And at the moment, it looks as though we've made a connection. When we put the line in place, we'll then discover whether the tunnels are connecting correctly. Now, we want the next one to come over here. Okay, so we've made the connection. Now we need to put the line in place. I'm going to go back to the hub, and I'm going to make the connection. And there's two sides to this. There should be, but it only wants. I should have the ability to put two sides to this in, because it's a two-way line. Why isn't it happening? Now that's a nuisance, isn't it? I need to find out why I can't put a line on both sides of that track. Okay, let's go with it to start with. Let's just follow around and see where we go. That's fine. Okay, so we put that stop in place there. Now we need to move across the next station, and another stop in there. Around to the next one, stop in there, another stop in there, coming down to the airport rail connection there, and then we're going to come to the international airport, and one in there. And if the line or the tunnel has been constructed properly, it should then join back over here, which yubba dubba do, it's done. You'll now throw up loads of metro trains. I need to remove them one after the other because there's not enough passengers to justify this lot. I'm just going to leave a couple on. That one can stay. And I'm also going to change the line colour. It always comes up green. Very strange, but I'm going to put a blue one in. So there we go. A few passengers waiting already. A few passengers being picked up, which is good going. So we now have one direction on this metro line. To be, I suppose, sensible, we need to actually come back the opposite way. That's how most lines would work. But what I wanted to really do here was to show you that as part of the mass transit system, the hub gives us the metro connection. Now we've actually done this, we've made the metro connection. We've linked it to the rest of the system. The next stage, of course, is to see what sort of volume of traffic goes between the metro station and the bus links. Over here, we've got the rail station. How many people are being picked up from a rail station? Over this side, we're in a passenger location only. This is where the sort of residential areas are. Over here, we've got this is probably an area which is not going to be heavily used. It's going to be this because it's really industrial over here, but it does get people to and from work. So there's no problem with actually putting it there. Over here, we've got the airport and the rail station, and we've also got the metro link as well, which is good going. And then we go to the international airport. That's now got two connections to the rest of the city. It's got the road system, and it's now got the metro system. So we've now got another link in the chain. Apart from the monorail, we've now got the rail connected to the metro. The metro is linked to the bus system and the airports. So it's looking quite good. So that's it for today. I hope you found this video useful. Please give me a thumbs up if you did. And please subscribe. I will be putting more videos on at least once a week, and I hope you will join me later. But that's all for today. Thanks and goodbye for now.